CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by the Cayenne, pure Porsche in a most unexpected form. The Intel Pentium 4 processor. Can a better computer really change your life? Yes, Intel. And by the Home Depot, driving down the cost of home improvement.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to one of the great rivalries in all of college athletics. Any sport, Duke and North Carolina about to tangle on the Tar Heels home court at the Smith Center here in Chapel Hill. Welcome, friends, Jim Nantz, Billy Packer, and Billy. This is the 214th meeting, and it's special every time these two meet.
Well, we just saw an incredible ending. Roy Williams of North Carolina beating Quinn Snyder of Duke, Missouri, Kansas. Be interesting here today if that's anything to tell what North Carolina may do, huh?
All right, Billy, we'll see.
It's been a crazy year.
It certainly has. And Carolina today starting its two seniors in their final scheduled home game, Will Johnson and Jonathan Holmes. While the Blue Devils go with Sanders, Sheldon Williams, Dante Jones, J.J. Redick, Chris Duhon.
I would imagine we will see a much more fired up Duke team than we saw play in Madison Square Garden last week.
The tip controlled by Duke. The Devils beat them February 5th at Cameron, 83-74, but it was a tight one with Duke controlling the final 6 minutes of that game.
It was tied 61-61 with 8 minutes, Jim. Zone defense, 2-3 by North Carolina.
Sheldon Williams comes up short.
Nice job by Manuel keeping his position.
Freshman Raymond Felton dumps it into Will Johnson. And a charge called on the senior. Coach K collected his 100th win at Duke in the month of March this week. In a victory over Florida State as the Devils closed out a perfect home slate, 15-0.
His 100th, Tim. He's got his 500th against North Carolina and his 600th against North Carolina.
That's off the rim, tipped around, controlled by Sanders, and then the putback, yes. Yes, his 100th in March.
There you go.
Doing some research on that. Boy, I tell you, there's some amazing numbers you'd never imagine. Bob Knight, maybe the winningest coach ever in the month of March, based on our totals.
Of course, a man that coached right here, Dean Smith, was a pretty good March coach as well.
Jawan Williams gives it up. Felton, he'll take the jumper, and he knocks it down for a two.
Dante Jones, that time, gave up on the ball. The most dangerous player, obviously, the man with the ball in his hands.
Redick back of the rim. Holmes wants to run with it. He'll wait up. No look pass. Williams. Long board Duhon. Duke on the run.
Duhon wanting to get in position against this 2-3 zone. He is. And Duhon doesn't see him right away.
Redick fires and the freshman hits a three.
It was a breakdown by the North Carolina defense. Duhon was open almost for 4 or 5 seconds. Matt Doherty up off that bench, very disappointed in that 2-3 zone. You cannot let him open in any area of the floor.
McCants outside, whistle on Duke. Matt Doherty in his third year, coaching his alma mater, former captain of the Tar Heels back in 1984.
And back in 01, his first game as a head coach against Duke, he came away victorious and hasn't had one since.
Six straight Blue Devil wins in this matchup, including four straight on this floor.
Well, no team has ever beaten North Carolina five straight times in the Dean Dome.
Williams jumper. Yes.
Sanders got an arm on him as well. Should have been a foul on that play. Nice follow through.
Jones with a three. And Sanders with a second offensive board. Gets it out of traffic. Whip it around. JJ for the second time. Redick no good.
Put that one up a little quick. But a much better job by Will Johnson getting out on him. Johnson is kind of exhausted right now. A little, so much energy in his final dime that he's going to play on this court. You can see it's kind of gotten to him a little bit. He was a starter, though, in his career at North Carolina in the past.
He started 16 games a season ago. McCants in the lane travel. Well, Billy Packer's alma mater, Wake Forest, won the league outright yesterday with its win over North Carolina State. The Demon Deacons' first outright ACC title since Billy's senior season of 1962.
Another incredible game by Josh Howard, 27 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 blocks, and 2 steals. Is there any question who's been the best player in this league this year?
I don't think there's any doubt. Jack Emanuel's in, number 5 for North Carolina. Williams back it in. On Williams. And out with it comes McCants.
Good pickup by Reddick. That time, not giving up on the ball. McCants was only 1-for-8 against Duke over in Durham, suffering from a bad back and a hip problem.
Felton on the drive. Scoop move. What a move there by Felton, the freshman.
Felton had an incredible game against Duke in Durham. 8-for-15, 25 points. He played 39 minutes. Crowd in this one right from the start, Jim. You think this North Carolina Duke would be playing as number 1 and 2 in the country, as they have in the past at times.
On the baseline, Duhon with the assist from Sheldon Williams.
Great look by Sheldon Williams on that play. If there's any big difference in this Duke team from now compared to February, is the fact that Williams now gives them an inside presence.
He has averaged almost a double-double the last 6 games. Sheldon Williams in the middle now for Duke. Jawad Williams pull up. Good box out, Manuel. And Sheldon Williams lands on him for the foul.
Probably moved Reddick right out on that block out, Jim, but got away with it.
That's Felton's nifty move for 2.
He did that over the number 3 shot blocker in the ACC. Quite a job for a guard.
As intense as you would imagine, Carolina and Duke off to a hot start. Back at North Carolina, Chapel Hill, Duke with the early edge. These two programs, Billy, in the last, 15 Final Fours, 13 of the Final Fours have included one or both of these programs.
Well, in the last 21 years, they've won 5 national championships. Duke with 3, North Carolina with 2.
Hand check outside on Chav Randolph, who has come in for Duke. Daniel Ewing also seeing his first action, number 5.
Duke has had 10 different starting lineups this year. They have 9 players, show how deep and how young they are. 9 players who've had double-figure games.
And a second on Randolph.
Good job by Felton. Very difficult to step out on him. As quick as he is, very gifted ball handler and extremely strong.
David Noel has come in for North Carolina, number 34, to turn over into the arms of Reddick. Duhon looks up court, finds his man in the corner. No. Ewing is saying his last touch by the Tar Heels, and they'll change the call back to Duke.
Jim, that turnover was on Duhon for going up in the air before he had a pass to make. It's a habit that he has that he's got to break.
But no turnover with the ball deflected by a Carolina defender. And this time it's Randolph drawing the foul on Jawad Williams. His first.
North Carolina got in serious foul trouble against Wake Forest. This team plays extremely hard. They get into foul trouble. They are small. They don't have an inside presence in regard to scoring with Sean May out, so that hurts them a time or 2.
Sean May, the freshman, injured 10 games into the season. They were hot early with him. Ewing rattles it home.
Pretty good touch there. Around the rim and back off the board and in.
Sean May out since December 27th with a broken left foot. He was practicing yesterday, though, rather vigorously.
Well, Randolph almost picked up his 3rd foul in about 30 seconds.
And Jawad Williams fires over the freshman.
Tough matchup. Rashavlik Randolph. He doesn't have anybody of size, so everybody he plays is getting him on quickness. A foul under the basket takes away the basket.
David Noel's effort. All for naught.
Noel, a tremendous game over in Durham against Duke. Extremely athletic, very tough. High school football star. Had a big game against Duke with 19 points and 7 rebounds. Now for Randolph to offset what's happening to him on the other end of the floor, he's got to get something going with low post action. Bad pass inside by Ewing.
Sheldon Williams will come back in for Duke. Randolph out.
There was no patience on that pass. You've got to give the bigger man an opportunity to not only get that post-up position, but settle in down there.
9-8 Duke, 6 minutes into the game. Felton bounces it over. Jawan Williams back out to McCants. Open three. Snap back out to Jawan.
Nice pass. If Williams had been ready, he'd have had himself a nice opportunity for a shot.
Manuel on the baseline. Yes!
You'd never know that this North Carolina team had themselves in a position where, as of yesterday, they even had a chance to have to play in the play-in game.
Count the basket for Duhon, and McCants on the block foul. Stepped in, they say.
McCants fouled out the other night against Wake Forest. Good drive that time by Duhon, taking it right down the lane. That's what I talked about, Jim, about going off the ground. A player like Duhon as a point guard has to stay on the ground unless he can deliver the shot to the basket for the layup.
He was slumping when they met a month ago, did not even earn the start against North Carolina, but second half he scored all 12 of his points on the game and had a double-double with 10 assists thrown in.
That was his first non-start coming off of that loss to Florida State. Reach.
Yeah, on Ewing. Dockery, make that. Dockery has just come in. Sean Dockery.
One of the things the players on both teams ought to recognize is how the referees are calling the game. All hand checking has been called early in this ball game, so there's no sense even thinking about going for steals. You got to play solid. Let the ball handler come to you.
McCants, Duhon on him. Wants to challenge Duhon and converts. McCants.
Again, there's that North Carolina with tough matchups. A lot of quick 6'4 and above players. Just went right over the top of Duhon that time, did McCants. The NIT preseason's most valuable player. Very capable.
Ewing gives it up to Williams, the trailer. Ewing had beaten McCants to the basket, but he gave it up to the big man for two.
Williams coming off that game against Florida State, 12 points and 17 rebounds. He has been unbelievable of late.
Jack Emanuel has it taken away. Active hands by Daniel Ewing.
Nobody picking him up again.
And dunked home again by Williams.
Terrific job by Ewing to recognize that nobody was stopping his dribble penetration, so he just kept right on going.
16-12 Blue Devils.
McCants asking to come out of the ball game right now. He's tired. Matt Doherty didn't even recognize it.
Jawan Williams with a three.
And I'm not saying he didn't recognize it because he didn't see him, or he didn't recognize it because right now he says, you know, we can't take somebody out of this ball game. Gonna have to play through being tired.
Dante Jones has been rather quiet here at the start.
Williams wants that ball inside. He's open again. He's screaming for it.
Ewing. Tracked down by Manuel.
Duke missed an opportunity to go down to the low post on that possession.
And again, a reach in on Ewing.
You can see how they're calling it, Jim. The players have yet to adjust.
The floor, and the Devils lead it by a point. Jim Nantz, Billy Packer here at Chapel Hill. Jawan Williams starring early for the Tar Heels. He's got 7. He had a similar first half at Duke where he had 14 in the first half.
Jim, North Carolina has had three straight games where they've shot over 60% and a half against Duke and still lost. So, you know, that's amazing that you could overcome that kind of shooting and still come back with a victory. Good job by Williams. Recognize they want to go the lob to Noel.
Noel, what a pass. Well, quick hands there for Duhon. Intercepts. Thought he pulled it off. Loose ball, chased down by McCants. Back to him for the lead.
This is a freshman to freshman on that play. A freshman steals the ball, passes to a freshman who passes back to a cutting freshman. Extremely young team, but they're not in awe of playing the Blue Devils.
Sheldon Williams finding room down low.
That was Duhon that time, so Williams feasting off of penetration drives and good dishes by the Duke guards.
Can't miss Manuel that time. He had beaten Ewing across the lane. Noel, Manuel cuts through. Smart move by Jackie Manuel. Saw his teammate in trouble. Cut to the basket.
Well, with nobody playing, and here a turnover. Dockery turns the ball over. It got away from him on the dribble. He was looking forward and didn't get it. But one of the things, Jim, that you'll notice, there is so much open court area down in the lane because North Carolina does not play with a low post player. So the quick cutting maneuvers that you're seeing Matt Doherty's team run right now really are tough to stop when there's nobody down guarding anybody in the pivot. It's wide open in the lane. Often you'll see five guys moving, nobody even in the paint.
Noel, that's a three. Long board, Dante Jones. Bounce pass into Dockery. Oh, on the fly, the freshman.
Chicago Player of the Year. Team is deep, aren't they? Particularly at the guard spot.
Melton spins away from him.
Tough shot.
Off balance, gets the roll.
What a tough shot against a terrific defender. Second miraculous shot that he's made today.
And he almost went up and got called for basket interference on his own shot. Couldn't believe how quick he got there. Eight lead changes in this game already. Williams in traffic, heads to the line.
North Carolina has no answer down inside. We see it inside. Dockery, a little bit of an incredible move on his own. Then we see Felton reverse dribble. Dockery can't get to him.
Watch how fast.
Oh, terrific job. And then here you
watch it come in.
Jim. Yep.
A foul was called on Felton. So Sheldon Williams, the landlord, as they call him. Last six game, averaging 12 points, 9 rebounds.
Jim, one of the things that you have to look at the pace of this game right now, Duke obviously a much deeper team than is North Carolina. The pace of this game really favors Duke. They're the leading scoring team in the ACC. North Carolina is seventh in a 9-team league.
Dante Jones, the Devils' leading scorer, goes to the bench. Leading scorer on the season, no points today. Lee Melchione, a freshman, replaces him. Two for two, Sheldon Williams. Taken out, Casey Sanders get his time.
Those North Carolina starters looking and saying, when is this revolving door going to start? Or stop, rather. Not a lot of substitutes. Sanders in the game now for North Carolina, favoring that ankle that he injured against Wake Forest the other night. And all Matt Doherty's trying to do with him is steal a few minutes.
That's 41, setting the pickup high. Taken off the court, crutches against Wake midweek. Right ankle sprain, and Melchione on the bump.
Another hand check foul.
It'll be a 1-1 now. Billy, we have some teams in the field of 65. Troy State.
UNC Asheville, coached by Eddie Biedenbach, former North Carolina State player, now has to wish that his alma mater gets a break.
Austin Peay, East Tennessee State. And Pennsylvania won the Ivy League.
East Tennessee State beating Chattanooga, coached by a former North Carolina player, Jeff Lebo.
Lebo. Yep.
And Jim, what we see in some of those tournaments are some huge upsets. Winthrop being beat by UNC Asheville. They've been almost a mainstay from the conference in the NCAA tournament.
With their coach, Greg Marshall, they have been in the last 4 years.
That's the first conference tournament, postseason tournament game he's lost.
Oh, three-point shot by Melvin Scott, who just comes into the game.
Well, I guess he remembers one of his relatives having a pretty good game against Duke a week ago, huh?
Just last Sunday, his cousin, Marcus Hatton. They both wear number one. We talked to Marcus last night after St. John's victory down in Miami, and St. John's with two more wins after the Duke victory last Sunday.
It's incredible what a mental approach, a positive mental approach, can mean to a ball club that was going nowhere and all of a sudden has gotten themselves together.
Redick gives it up, Dockery. Casey Sanders from Dockery.
Jim, that is 400% shots that the Duke big men have gotten inside on dribble penetration. North Carolina has no answer for that.
Reach in on Dockery. His second. Now you're going to be hearing this speculation for the next week until next Sunday, Selection Sunday. Number one seeds, how do you see it at the moment, though?
Well, Kansas really helped themselves today with those two incredible shots. Texas, with that win over Oklahoma, being down 15, coming back to win. I think the two guys at the top are there. I think out of Texas, Kansas, Oklahoma, and Florida, I don't see anybody else getting the number one seed other than coming out of that bunch with two of them really set.
So those four for two spots for two ones.
And the SEC and the Big 12, the two toughest leagues this year, are certainly going to be well represented at the top.
To be called on Casey Sanders.
Well, I talked about Sanders, and I'm talking about North Carolina Sanders now, stealing some minutes. There he steals a minute and a foul.
Dockery out, Dante Jones back in. That's the ninth Duke foul, so a 1-1. Next Saturday, Billy, selection weekend, we'll have the Conference USA Championship on Saturday. Look at the time, 11:30 Eastern. And that'll be followed by the Big Ten semifinals. We'll be in Chicago for that, presented by Intel. Then the Pacific Life Pac-10 title game next Saturday evening on CBS. Sanders missing that front end.
The foul shooting has really hurt North Carolina this year.
Scott had a three.
Oh, what a steal!
Duhon read it, and he's called. Felton's called for the foul.
Late whistle on that one. That was some action between two unbelievably explosive players. Jim, North Carolina lost a ball game against NC State in overtime here about 10 days ago or so. In that game, North Carolina State shot 22 for 22 from the foul line. North Carolina shot 7 for 19. And when you lose in overtime and give up those kind of free shots, they lost the same in overtime to Miami, shooting the same way from the foul line. Games that they had put away, even for a young team, just because of the inability to make foul shots.
Duhon able to hit the front end of the 1-1 at the other end. 7 out of 19, you think about that.
Yep.
You know the team perfect. Seldom do you see that.
Well, they missed one, but North Carolina jumped in the lane too early, and Josh Powell got another opportunity. So ended up 22 for 22 in the game.
Another lead change back to Duke. Dwight Williams fade away and gets the soft roll.
There's another one of those tough matchups. Casey Sanders in the open floor, not able to stay up with Williams. Dante Jones looking to get on track.
Reach in, Noel.
Now, one of the things that I like about the way that this game is being officiated, not necessarily the calls, but it's been consistent. Hand checking both ends of the floors. The players and coaches then have to adjust, and they haven't done it so far.
Ewing from Elkioni, and a reminder throughout the week, you can follow along with live play-by-play action. The conference champions are crowned through Selection Sunday. Just go to CBSSportsLine.com or on America Online under the keyword CBS Sportsline. 1-1, Dante Jones. First miss from the line for Duke. 5 for 6, the Devils, and Carolina 1 out of 4. McCants banks it home.
McCants doesn't worry when he's being guarded by somebody the size of Duhon and Ewing. He just goes in and plays right over the top of them. Redick not getting any open room to shoot.
Almost came out with it. And that's going to be called on Ewing.
Nice defensive job by McCants. Instead of reaching in, he moved his feet. Matt Doherty loved it.
Second on Ewing. Back and forth we go in Carolina on a 7-0 run. We're back in Chapel Hill. The Singular Wireless Fan Poll. Who do you think will win ACC Player of the Year? Singular Wireless users send votes 171 or log on to cbssportsline.com/singular. Stay tuned for the results during Singular at the Half. And there's Sean May again out since December the 27th. Freshman made such a big impact early in the season. Just can't imagine what this team would have been had he been healthy all season.
Jim, I'm confused, though. Yesterday, you and I watched North Carolina practice. He was in a full sweat playing full court and full scrimmage, contact scrimmage. You wonder why, if he can scrimmage full time and get a full sweat up, why is he not playing some minutes out here now? We saw him out here an hour before the game shooting, no noticeable limp. I'm not trying to say that there's anything wrong with what their trainers have decided, but if you can play full court scrimmage, you certainly can play in a game like this.
Decided a couple of weeks ago that they were going to sit him out for the rest of the season, but having played 10 games, not eligible for a medical redshirt or anything like that.
It wouldn't make any difference.
Wouldn't make any difference if he'd come back for one or two games at the end. Now,
that's a nice job by Williams not to go for the block. McCann's just trying to draw the foul. Boy, Williams is getting great post-up position.
Unable to finish. Arms angled underneath. Williams and Williams.
Nice piece of officiating, though. They look back and check on it.
Scott, charge.
A fouls and fatigue, Jim. 5:46 to go in this half. North Carolina with a very short bench. Really no place to go compared to what Mike Krzyzewski has been doing in this game. It looks like Mike is coaching this game to get through the first half to try to wear down and keep this pace up, wear down the Tar Heels.
Belton comes back in for the Tar Heels. And Nick Horvath, one of the captains. He and Dante Jones.
Makes what, the 11th player that's been on the floor for Duke so far in this game.
Ball last.
Off the foot of North Carolina.
Yeah, no doubt.
Another nice piece of officiating, helping each other out.
Redick. Oh, yes. Three-pointer.
And that play was worked on by North Carolina yesterday in practice. The object was to fight over and stay with him no matter what. Manuel was late getting there. Redick doesn't need much room.
Redick three, ties it at 29. Pass too steep. Taken away by Dockery.
Williams tired, slow getting down the floor.
Horvath inside, and last touch by Duke.
Turnover. That time, Dockery getting too close. No spacing for the pass.
Well, a year ago, as North Carolina suffered through that 8-20 season, Duke beat them here 87-58, the worst loss ever by the Tar Heels at the Smith Center. It's been a different story here today as McCants gives North Carolina the lead back.
Excellent low post player for a man his size. Such a tough matchup. Well, in 1986, these two teams opened this arena, Jim. And at that time, Duke was ranked number three, North Carolina number one, North Carolina coming away with a win. There's that dribble penetration, and either, in that case, Duhon going to the basket. But four times today, Duke guards have gone to the basket, made the dish, and the big men finished it off.
Jones, in the last meeting, had 23 points, 13 rebounds, which is a career high, looking for his first points of the game. That foul on Noel, his second. And Sheldon Williams for Horvath.
Well, the other night in the Florida State game in which Duke avenged the loss, isn't it unbelievable Florida State could beat them 2 years in a row down at Florida State? Avenged that loss, they had a nice working margin and then kind of just went through the motions for the last 12 minutes or so. Dante Jones tried a behind-the-back pass on a 4-and-1 break, and it took Mike Krzyzewski about 0.1 seconds to get up off of that bench and usher the senior out. Counts on solid play at all times.
Sheldon Williams left his feet.
About the only guy that Duke has that could guard McCants in that position is Dante Jones. McCants is playing right over the guards. There's Williams again asking for the ball. There he is.
Banks it home.
There is no answer.
Sheldon Williams now with 10.
He's getting such wide body position, and he makes whoever's guarding him look so small down there.
Cutting to the basket, McCants for two more. He has 12. 35-33, North Carolina.
McCants looking like he did against Kansas and Stanford in Madison Square Garden earlier this year.
The preseason NIT MVP, Carolina NIT preseason champs.
Back to the zone goes Matt Doherty in hopes that he can keep Williams off the board.
Redick with his third three to give Duke the lead by one. He averages three made threes a game.
Take your poison either way. He's behind Pickett from Florida State, number one three-point goal shooter in the conference in terms of threes made per game.
Lead goes to North Carolina.
Nice no call on that drive. And here's the zone again. Williams has got his man pinned on a rotation. All he wants is a lob pass.
Redick. Not this time. Williams. Oh, in and out. Noel tipped it out. Duke ball.
Jim, you can see on a diagonal pass, Williams can get a lob against his zone, score easily.
We have had 17 lead changes in the first half. Back for the final 2:41 of the first half. Billy, you look at the field goal percentage for North Carolina.
Isn't that amazing?
68%.
That's the fourth half that they've played against Duke in which they've shot over 60% and lost the three previous games.
You know, we have a big dignitary now as our stage manager this week. Go right over here. There he is, Sam Weish. Good to have you with us, Coach. Doing a nice job. Coached the Bengals to Super Bowl 23. And a great friend, CBS Sports, the great Sam Weish. You know, he used to be our stage manager. He's also here today. Matt Doherty for 3 or 4 years.
I don't know if we ever even elevated him to stage manager.
Oh, yeah.
He was just kind of the guy that went for the coach. He went for coach in 88 to Final Four with Kansas, and then he became the assistant coach. We really helped advance his career.
Oh, McCants
again
with 14 on the game.
There is no matchup. You know, I got to give Coach Doherty a lot of credit for this. Remember when McCants asked to come out earlier in the game, and Matt just ignored him and said, not today. This is the day you've got to gut it out, and McCants certainly has.
Jones way short on that one. Follows it, though. He traveled. Coming up singular at the half, Greg Gumbel will get you caught up on all the latest college basketball news and highlights. Plus, Billy and Clark Kellogg will jump it up on a variety of hot topics. Coming up on singular at the half, we have an even 2 minutes to go before halftime. Carolina leading by three. Does this surprise you, Billy?
It really doesn't. I've seen North Carolina play on numerous occasions. This team plays extremely hard. A lot of times they run out of gas. And then they have problems down the stretch, I think primarily because of their immaturity as a team. But they have played extremely hard all year long. And playing without a postman since May went out makes it even more incredible that they hang in there.
Dalton, maybe forced that one. Loose change, though. Picked up by Jawad.
McCants kept it alive.
Tipped around into the arms of Dockery. To the man in the corner, Jones.
No call inside.
Ball tipped around. Emmanuel has it.
And there was Sanders doing a good job preventing Jones from getting an easy layup.
Felton spin move. Baseline. Sanders doesn't take the shot.
How quick is that first step by McCants?
Hard to stay up with him. For anyone. Sanders gives it up last second. Manuel goes to the other side and they'll head to the line.
Hey, two nice plays by Sanders.
McCants, a quick first step and a great finish, too.
Jim, this basket by North Carolina. Give Sanders credit for knowing what not to do out there. He knows that he caught that ball. He might have been open, but that's not the shot that they want him to take. And then he gives the ball up inside.
Manuel, again, they struggle at the line. And this young man in particular at Duke cost him at the line. He was 0 for 5 at Cameron from the free throw line. Carolina now 1 for 5 in this game.
McCants finally gets a chance to sit down with a minute and 10 to go. Gutty performance on his part.
14 points. The bench with one foul. Manuel connects on the second.
One of the things about Manuel's foul shot, Jim, you notice how his back stays so rigid on the shot and it's going backwards. There's the 2-3 zone. Again by North Carolina. They've been switching back and forth.
Minute to go in the half and the Tar Heels steal it. Melvin Scott.
Scott got a piece of that.
Off on the jumper. Tipped up once, twice. Loose ball picked up by Dockery again. Been in there a couple of times, pulled it away. Redick.
Duke is looking to take shots much too quickly. If they'll take their time against that zone, they'll find out that they can throw the diagonal pass to Williams because there's nobody of any size to stop him.
McCants comes back in for this last possession of the half. Will Johnson expelled him for a moment.
Good decision by Daugherty.
The shot by Redick went over the backboard. And Gus gives it back to North Carolina.
And you notice the matchup. Mike Krzyzewski goes Jones on McCants. It's the only guy that he's got that matches up with him.
Let's see if this young team can be patient enough to, in fact, bring it down to the last shot.
Daugherty better not reach. He'll get a call for another cheap check, hand check foul. Right now, he should just try to play solid.
Felton with 11 seconds. How large will the lead be at the half? Felton drives in, puts it up off the glass. Yes! 4 seconds to go in the half. Redick looks up, launches from midcourt, and it's just short. Duke misses its last eight from the field in the first half. That's the end of the first half. They're going crazy here in Chapel Hill. Carolina leads at 42-36. Let's go to Greg in New York for Singular at the Half.
All right, Jim, thank you. And coming up on Singular at the Half, all the latest basketball news, plus Billy Packer and Clark Kellogg will jump ball on the hottest topics in college hoops. All of that and more comes your way after this message and a word from your local station.
North Carolina leading at halftime by 6. The Tar Heels looking for a performance today that would make their season against arch rival Duke. They didn't have to stir the crowd too much. They've been in it from the get-go. With plays like that by Raymond Felton, Sheldon Williams has starred for the Devils, but McCants has controlled the inside with 14 points, and the Tar Heels are springing the surprise at the moment. 42-36, second half coming up.
Pop it. CBA Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by NikeBasketball.com. 10-10-220 for great long distance rates anywhere in America and around the world. Dial 10-10-220. And by Papa John's Pizza. Better ingredients, better pizza.
Second half about to get underway, and in that first half, well, for the fourth straight encounter with these two, North Carolina shoots better than 60% of the first half.
They shot 62 against Duke and Durham. It's amazing.
Three-pointers, only Redick connected from the outside for Duke. He was 3 out of 7, 0 for 5 from the rest of the Devils.
I thought the pace of the game took away Duke's opportunity to hit the threes, and here you can see rebounding. In their losses, Duke this year is -5 in the rebound. In their wins, they're a +4.5, an area where they really got to pick it up.
And McCants leading all scorers with 14, Sheldon Williams 10 on the Duke side. Fifth time this season, the Devils have trailed at halftime at 21-5 on the season, trying to, well, not only improve, but maintain a high seed, a good seed in the NCAA tournament. And the North Carolina only chance of making it to the NCAAs would be to run the tables at next week's ACC tournament in Greensboro.
Well, fortunately for North Carolina, they won't have to win four games, Jim, because they will not be in the play-in game. That looks like that's going to be Virginia, potentially against Florida State.
North Carolina does, though, need a win either today or a win in the ACC tournament to get into the NIT. And Jones with his first basket of the game. He had missed all five field goal attempts in the first half.
Jones smart dribbling on that play because he knew McCants was with him. McCants has the ability to go up and pin that ball. Here's that matchup. Sanders on Williams, giving up a lot of quickness there, having a hard time staying with it.
Williams with the put back. No, short. Sheldon Williams for Duke clears.
Duke starting with a tall team out here now. Let's see if they take their time and pound inside a little bit.
They do have their size with Casey Sanders and Sheldon Williams. And Dante Jones trying to erase that first half performance with the second basket here in the first minute.
Well, the game in Durham, the score was 61-61, and then Duke ran off 11 straight possessions where they scored. Blew that game open in what was very, very tight.
Dance, Manuel, stuck for a moment. Noel, and taken away by Duke.
Got some numbers here.
Backing him in, Sheldon Williams ties it at 42.
Now you can see what Duke did at halftime, Jim. They figure that they've worn North Carolina down somewhat in that first half, and now they come out big and go right inside to Williams, something that they could have done, I think, much more favorably in the first half.
Get up! Kants breaks the ice for the second half for the Tar Heels.
He created that shot out of nothing.
He is something special, 16 for Rashad McCants.
Well, the young man, the first game he ever played at North Carolina, scored 28, the most points of it. Freshman ever scored in his opening game for this club.
Freshman Reddick. And tipped out.
Dangerous place to tap that ball.
Felton to Jawad Williams, back to Felton. Jawad with the three. On the floor and saved again at the under the opponent's basket. Reddick tipped away by Manuel. Good ball.
Reddick was looking to make a pass on that drive. Williams not open.
Boy, McCants creating a shot.
This is unbelievable how he got this one off inside, surrounded by three players and still banked it in. Williams wanted a guard to come take the ball from him. Everybody broke away.
Duhon, long range.
Not the shot you want. When you've got a situation where you've got your bigger players in the game, you've got to go inside first and then kick it out.
Lob it over the top, and Sheldon Williams called Casey Sanders for the hold. So Kansas with that incredible flurry in the final minute with Aaron Miles and Kirk Heinrich hitting off-balance threes, winning it. Illinois, Minnesota, that was an important game for the Gophers today, but throttled by Illinois.
Some interesting games in the Big Ten. How about Penn State beating Indiana? There's another cut without the ball. This one by Noel. The open offense from North Carolina paying off. Now let's see if Duke will take advantage of their inside power. Nope. Another quick shot from the outside.
And Carolina hustles to the front court. Manuel posting up Reddick. Kicks it back out. Noel will take the three. Yes! Suddenly a seven.
A good job by North Carolina in the second half to do what they have at their best advantage, which is an open court area. Duke not taking advantage of their strengths.
Duke comes right out of the half, scores the first six to tie it. Now seven unanswered for Carolina. Sheldon Williams on the run. Casey Sanders inside and one. Monday on CBS, an all-new night of America's best television, starting with the King of Queens, then Yes, Dear, Everybody Loves Raymond, and Still Standing, then TV's new show, new number one show, CSI Miami. And an all-new David Letterman after your local news, all here Monday on America's Most Watched Network. That's the third foul on David Noel.
Jimmy, you know, it's kind of interesting. We talked at the beginning of the show talking about the incredible tradition between these two schools. In the 23 years that Mike Krzyzewski has been at Duke, these two teams have faced each other where one team was number one in the country 18 times. And it's kind of amazing. 12 times Duke's been number one, 6 times North Carolina. Chadwick Randolph doesn't put it away. North Carolina out-hustles them.
And coming out with it is Felton.
And this crowd really into the game, showing a tribute to how hard their team is playing.
Sanders rejected by Sanders of Duke. Wow, what a stop by Casey. Corner, Redick takes the fire, goes inside, pin it for Randolph. Last touch by McCants. A spurt by Duke, but right back comes Carolina with the lead by 5.
Plays easy getting to the madness. Make your move to the madness on CBS.
Jim Nantz and Billy Packer here in Chapel Hill, back with the Singular Wireless Fan Poll. Who will be the ACC Coach of the Year? Who deserves it? Singular Wireless users, send vote. 171 or log on to cbssportsline.com/singular, and we'll have the results later in the half.
Little hint to the fans, one team was picked to be 6th preseason, won the championship outright. I would think that coach got a pretty good shot.
I like his chances.
Close out position by North Carolina and Redick all day long, just not giving him any open looks for 3.
Jones with the floater.
Now that's a shot he's always had in his arsenal. Even when he was in the Big East, the mid-range jump shot. What's improved his game is the ability to step outside farther. How about that crosser?
And Randolph helped knock it away, and it's Duke ball.
There are a lot of guys with quick first steps, but I'll tell you, between Felton and McCants, I don't know if any one team has two guys with quicker first steps than those two.
The highest scoring freshman duo in North Carolina history, veterans Stackhouse and Wallace.
Well, Stackhouse and Wallace had a little bit better players to play with in the upper classes when they were here.
He took some of those points.
Yeah.
Away from him. And that ball still belongs to Duke.
Nice job by Williams defensively. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Duke without their power inside players now. Chadwick Randolph on the floor for Williams.
Redick. And Jawad Williams is there to clear it. Duke has made only 3 out of 17 from behind the arc. Remakes were by Redick. And Randolph, is it Randolph?
I think that was a push.
Jones.
I think it was Jones pushing from the, using that elbow, pushing from the back.
Looking at the Big Ten brackets, you were talking about Indiana losing to Penn State yesterday. We'll meet again Thursday at the United Center. We'll be there next week, Billy. Purdue and Michigan State in the 4-5 game. Wisconsin with its first outright conference title in over 50 years.
That's right. They were in a four-way tie before here recently, but an outright and a great move by Wisconsin. You know, when you figure preseason, Michigan State, Illinois, teams that were expected to be up there, Wisconsin not expected to finish anywhere near outright number one champion.
Juwan Williams, 2 for 2. And it's a 5-point Carolina lead.
Holding, try to keep Ewing from breaking out around the screen.
Called on Jack Emanuel. With the conclusion of this game, we will select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund, the tradition now for 30 years. Andrew Ewing thought about it, gave it up to Williams.
Lost the handle on it.
Gets it back for the lay-in.
Ball squirted right out of Williams' hands. And that's hard to do with the balls he's got. again, and can't seeing Ewing on him, said, you know, you're too small to guard me. I'm taking it inside. One of the few times you see a guy steal the ball from behind and not get called for the foul. McCants' eyes lights up when he sees him being guarded by smaller people. And North Carolina would be smart this time to give McCants a chance to go inside on the smaller guards.
Again, this Duke team really did not see McCants in that first game. He played 10 painful minutes with a back injury. Scored only 2 points, and this ball is going Duke's way with the arrow.
Smart play by Duhon. He saw his teammate going down with the ball and got the look from the official, did Duhon, who was not involved in the play. That was a very smart play.
Well,
here's the switch. Williams went up, got the block. You'll watch that Duhon, who is not involved in this play, is the guy that called the timeout and got it.
So the timeout there called by Duke. North Carolina clinging to a 51-48 lead. Under 14 minutes to play. And taken away by the Tar Heels. McCants doubled up and stripped back.
Smart play by Dockery to pull it back out. Duke still, for some reason, will not go inside to a wide open Williams, who could change the complexion of this game completely.
Dante Jones gets the roll.
Isn't it interesting when you get players like Jones and McCants that people can't match up with? When they post it downside against guards, they just go over the top of them.
Jones with 10, 8 in this half. Williams turn around and tipped out to Ewing. Ewing on the fly, and it rims out.
Very poor judgment. Duke had good numbers, had the floor spread. Ewing made for no pass opportunity.
That's a three. And Sheldon Williams with the position. Long outlet. Dockery spinning off balance.
Terrible shot selection on two possessions by Duke. It's amazing they've gotten caught in this up and down frenzied game and are not using their heads at all as to where they have the advantage.
That's on Ewing, his third. Jones with a different second half performance. After only two made free throws in the first half.
Well, Dante, as you mentioned earlier, Jim, coming off that great game against North Carolina where he had 23 points and 13 rebounds over in Durham, really picking it up in the second half. But he sits right now.
Casey Sanders takes his time.
McCants is also down right now, trying to get a little bit of a rest for the stretch drive. Expended so much energy in that first half.
Scott dishes inside. Back out to him.
Sanders is wide open with Williams on him, but they know he has no offensive moves, so reluctant to passing the ball.
Felton penetrates and cleared by Duke. And they're going to call.
Is that a travel or is that going to be a foul?
They call traveling, I believe. Carolina ball when we come back. It's called traveling.
CBA Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Siemens. Siemens, global network of innovation. Pepto-Bismol, first aid for stomachs, uses directed. And by Sprint, introducing PCS Vision, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
Billy, take a look at the teams with the highest RPI.
Well, Kentucky and Arizona, we all talked about being in there. Texas is going to be hard to keep out of a number one seed. Oklahoma still battering for one. Marquette, a real outside chance, Jim, if you take a look at it. But I think one of the things that everybody has to understand, the RPI is not the say-all, be-all, and end-all. There'll be a lot of other things that are taken in consideration.
How about Wake winning the regular season if it wins the ACC
tournament?
Well,
they make a run. But Marquette beat Wake Forest, so there's a lot of ifs now in these postseason conference tournaments that could be a factor. That's a foul on Duhon, reaching in. The players have done a very good job in this second half understanding how the game was being refereed. Remember the start of this game, Jim, all the hand checking that we saw. Referees have been consistent. Players made the proper adjustment. Backdoor cut,
and Felton converts. Byron Sanders found him.
Well, Sanders has given North Carolina some valuable minutes. He won't show up big on the stat charts, but just the ability to be out there and take up these minutes and some fouls to give McCants a rest.
Next Sunday, the moment of truth. Who's in, who's out? Who's playing whom and when? You'll get it first, get it fast, right here on CBS. The NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show. For more, go to CBSSportsLine.com, America Online, keyword CBS Sports Line. Byron Sanders with his second foul. Third team foul of the half.
Duhon wasn't ready to make the pass. Redick was open on the cut.
Duhon penetrates, left hand.
We saw that last week against St. John's. He loves that floater. Carolina's had McCants out for a while.
Oh, Jim Williams with a pure jumper.
Jim, right here you see Coach Doherty really taking a gamble. He's got a little bit of a margin here. Wants to make sure that McCants and Manuel are fresh going down the stretch, knowing how much energy McCants had put into the game up to this point.
Sheldon Williams backing in Sanders. That
use
big
that
body.
Yeah. And there's what North Carolina cannot stop. Duke, for some reason, seems to want to get away from it. Their guards have to recognize that advantage. Ewing on the foul on Scott. Away from the ball. No reason necessary to foul there at all.
And that's the fourth on Daniel Ewing. Team foul number five. Very similar pattern here, though, for Carolina in terms of shooting percentages. The last four matchups with Duke, over 60% in the first half. In the other four or three counters, they were 33% in the second half.
What an impact.
Juwan Williams, back-to-back baskets.
Felton just paralyzed the Duke defense with that penetration inside. Sanders trying to hold his own in there, but just not strong enough for Williams.
That one on Sanders. His third. Jones wants to challenge. Juwan Williams rejected by Byron Sanders.
This young man is playing some valuable minutes. Jones goes, has it made, and then Sanders comes over to help out. And had a what looked like a devastating injury against Wake Forest earlier. And coming back today very strong.
Oh, Dante Jones.
Dante's asking for the fans to start cheering. He's got to realize that they're all here rooting for the other team.
He got a reaction out of it, though. Yeah, he put his arms up, started waving after that two-point shot. Noel back to the rim. Sanders saves it with a possession for the Tar Heels. Juwan Williams travel. Tonight on CBS 60 Minutes, former President Bill Clinton, former Senate Majority Leader Bob Dole joined the cast of 60 Minutes. And then that'll be followed by My Big Fat Greek Life, Becker, and the CBS Sunday Night Movie. And Duke has the lead back with that three-point basket by Redick.
Just give him a little bit of room, and now Matt Doherty brings McCants back to the ball game. See if he can get him in here on this next possession. He should be well rested.
And Scott for the lead back, yes!
Scott had 5 of 7 threes against Davidson earlier this year, so he is certainly capable.
Williams, soft hook, second chance.
And foul, no call, or yes?
Yes, call.
They can't handle him inside.
Call on Williams. Make that on Sanders, his fourth. And Byron Sanders to the bench. McCants comes back.
Williams leads this team with 6 double-doubles. And Jim, in the first game, now just think about this, and this shows how much he has progressed. In the first game against North Carolina this year, he played 2 minutes and did not score. Now he is the factor for Duke.
Looking for his 19th point of the game.
Ball.
Over the backboard, Carolina ball. Under 9 minutes to play. Duke leads at 61-60.
Let's see McCants, Noel, the matchups. Here comes McCants, blows right by you.
And one.
There was no matchup. That first step just exploded right by Ewing. He's got strength. He's got explosive quickness. And the young man knows how to score.
And he's got game. That's the third foul on Dante Jones. McCants. The 19 now. 63-61, Carolina.
Now he comes up big in big games too. He had 25 against Kansas, 22 against the likes of Kentucky. Well, out there, tough guy to shoot over.
Inside foul on Jawad Williams.
Duke is now starting to recognize that there is no answer for Williams inside, being much more patient, looking to get him the ball down inside. And what's going to happen here? North Carolina is going to have to put so much pressure on Williams that he'll be able to kick back out for a Redick three.
Juwan Williams with his second. Team foul number 6. Jones, McCants got a hand on it.
How about the vertical leaps we're seeing in here?
Got a player down for North Carolina.
I think it's Felton. I think he got hit in the eye. Dante Jones showing incredible vertical leaping. McCants stayed with him on the first one. Here was Felton, was actually down while all this action was taking place. See what happens to him here. Yeah, he got hit right in the eye by Jones. And see, he stays on the ground. It's 5-on-4 here. There's where he swipes him with a hand. Going for the loose ball. Oh, we got a fight over here. Matt Doherty exchanged a shove with a Duke player. Now, I want to point something out. Doherty and Jones had a problem at the game in Durham. Jones made some gestures at Doherty. Doherty actually went down the sidelines in that game to tell Mike Krzyzewski about it. Now, Mike is trying to get Matt, who's a very emotional guy, to go down at his end of the floor. Fortunately, the incident in Durham did not break out into anything like this. And Jim, remember now, if that was a punch throw and you get that situation of the fight with the suspensions, let's see if the referees are going to go look at this.
Chris Collins, it's Collins and Doherty.
All right. Two feisty players in their days.
And now Doherty's trying to get his players out of the mix.
Wojo down in there, Johnny Dawkins, all the former Duke players, but Collins and Doherty. Now Collins telling Coach K what took place. Oh, it was Collins talking to McCants, and what Doherty's saying, don't you talk to my players.
And then Andre Buckner got caught in between the Duke player. He got into it with the Carolina coach. Not a pretty scene here at Chapel Hill. We'll be right back. To reset this heated exchange, Felton took a blow to the mouth. His coach came down to argue a bit. Assistant coach Chris Collins of Duke starts talking to a Carolina player, McCants. And now the head coach and the assistant coach get into it. And Andre Buckner decides to also lend his opinion.
Buckner makes the first push on Doherty. You see that Felton has some cuts on his lip. And that will require some medical attention. And hopefully North Carolina can get that done quickly so he can get back into this ball game. Because obviously you can't play with that blood flowing.
They talked to the coaches during what was an official timeout. Hey, looking at it a couple of times.
Oh, Matt's still pushing to Mike, and did not like the fact that Chris Collins came over there and got in that conversation at all.
They've got double technicals on each bench.
Well,
technicals on each bench.
And as I said, there was a heated exchange between Matt Doherty and Dante Jones at the game at Durham this year, in which Matt Doherty went down the sidelines to Mike Krzyzewski's bench and said he doesn't need that from another player.
After this game, and people review that tape, will there be any penalties against any of the participants? Collins, Doherty, or Buckner?
The only thing resembling even a push or a punch would have been Buckner's punch, so I don't think that we'll see that. Nothing is shot. Game 63-63. And everybody said this game means nothing, but I'll tell you what, schools are 8 miles apart, and this is some rivalry.
Just a little neighborhood argument. McCants, front of the rim, and Sheldon Williams again controlling the inside of this game.
McCants would like to have that one back. A wide open look from 8 feet. Now it's Noel on Williams. Noel much stronger than was Sanders, but still no chance to stop the power man.
Dante Jones, turn around and a whistle. And it's against the Tar Heels.
Tremendous energy we're seeing out here now, Jim, on part of both of these teams. Amazing.
Melvin Scott called for that.
And here's Felton coming back into the ball game. So they got that bleeding stop. He was fortunate not to get any on his uniform, and that they were able to get a stop because it was right around his mouth area.
Two shots for Jones. You know, Billy, given that you had the Carolina coach in the area, you had such heated exchange, it could have been a lot worse.
Oh, absolutely. Matter of fact, I think Doherty pulling back away from that probably helped that situation considerably. And obviously the reason he was down in that area is because Felton was laying on the ground. He was looking for
looking after his player.
Yeah.
We have our 20th lead change of the game. Hands down low, works the body, and make that 21 lead changes.
He has all day shown the Duke guards that they cannot handle him in the low post area. Even when he misses, like he did on that last occasion, he has good open looks.
Redick in the lane, short of the jumper.
Not a shot that he normally gets either.
And Felton battles the big guys, comes away with it. Three, yes!
Huge shot. Felton has been looking to penetrate all game. That time pulled up, and Felton comes up with a Duke technique, slams the floor defensively.
Gives him a 4-point lead with that three.
Williams running that ball inside.
Ewing rattles it home. And a timeout called by Duke. Quick timeout by Duke.
What I think you're seeing right here is a change in defensive assignment thinking, Jim. They know that McCants has gone down inside to post up. They've got to make some help moves down inside, doubling down on McCants.
Billy, let's take a look at our Microsoft Agile move.
Been so many of them today. I'm anxious to see which one they pull up. Belt. McCants. Well, there were, you know what? I wouldn't have voted for that one, Jim, and we've seen a ton of them today. But in any case, McCants has been a wonder down in that low post.
McCants with 21 to lead the Tar Heels. Again, a game, a performance that would make their season.
Absolutely.
50% of the second half for North Carolina. We're down in the 20s in the early stages of this half. Midway through, actually. McCants has it stripped away.
It's off Ewing's hand.
And it's North Carolina ball with 23 on the shot clock.
Good block by Williams. McCants taking it right out at Ewing. Ewing has four fouls. I thought they might even switch Dante Jones over to McCants going down the stretch.
A shot. Nope. Gets it back. Banks it home over Sheldon Williams.
Remember in the first half, Jim, the miraculous shot he made, and as you said, almost followed up for the goaltend. There he is, one of the smallest guys on the floor. Right now he is the smallest guy, getting his own offensive rebound.
He's made a three and a two after getting popped in the mouth, and Dante Jones slams it down.
The senior coming to the front. Had a very weak first half, but he has been sensational in the second.
15 in this half. Kantz takes it inside and lays it in.
Duke will have to put Dante Jones on him. Ewing is no threat to stop him.
This was the point in their first meeting where Duke just took over, scored on its last 11 possessions. Ewing back in the rim.
Over the back comes Manuel, no call.
They say Carolina ball. Sheldon Williams was battling three Tar Heels for the rebound.
I thought Manuel came over his back. No call made.
It sure looked like it.
And let's see, the change is still not made. Duke's going to go into his zone.
Four-point lead and possession.
Yep, Duke goes to his zone. They can't stop McCants or Felton, so they go zone. North Carolina down just a little bit here, trying to recognize. Good time for Matt Doherty to call a timeout, I think, Jim.
He's got 14 seconds, his team, on the shot clock.
I think it would have been worth a timeout here because his team is facing the defense they hadn't seen in a while. We're going to attack anyway.
And on the shot clock, Manuel driving, stripped away by Sheldon Williams. Out to Duhon. Reach in by Manuel.
Double team. And Duke calls a timeout.
4:45 left in this game. It has been a thriller. 72-68 Tar Heel. Chapel Hill, North Carolina leading by four. Arizona with a win over Oregon yesterday. Arizona and Kentucky, sure number one seats next week. Selection Sunday on CBS a week away. The exclusive live announcement right here. Sheldon Williams working hard for position inside.
Double, triple down.
Duhon, three-pointer. Too strong. Reset by Williams. Slams it down. He is taken over inside.
Mike Krzyzewski wanting a foul on the play as well, but Williams knocked his man to the floor. Let's see what Duke does defensively. They stay in their little matchup. Are they going back to man-to-man? They are.
Matchup zone, Jim.
It's a matchup zone.
Felton inside, stripped away by Redick. Clean steal, they say. Two to tie. Three for the lead. Jones, that's a two-point shot. Cleared by Jawad Williams.
I really think North Carolina should get a timeout and figure out this defense just to settle this extremely young team down. You can see they're not sure where they should even be positioned on the floor. This defense primarily takes McCants low post out of it.
Williams just raised the front of the rim. It'll be Duke ball. That shot taken with three on the shot clock. Official timeout. 3:10 left in the game. 2-point Tar Heel lead. Back at the Dean Smith Center. And earlier we asked you, who do you think will win ACC Coach of the Year? Here are the results from your voting. Keep watching for more Singular Wireless fan poll questions.
Pretty well-informed group of fans. And
can't argue with that. That's no question there. It picked sixth in the preseason. Interesting, Carolina picked seventh preseason.
And that was with Sean May expected to be in their lineup. This team has played hard. I've seen them play a number of times. Unfortunately, they've gotten down the wire and it's either been fouls or inexperience that got them in trouble. very poor shot selection for Duke.
And a good box out by McCants.
Now, Duke looks like they got out of the matchup. Ewing thought they were still in the matchup. Everybody else was playing man-to-man. Now Williams is back in the matchup situation.
Billy, you've been saying they didn't know how to adjust. North Carolina in their last three possessions against that Duke zone, two turnovers and a missed shot on the third possession.
Well, now let's see how they match up. See, they're back into basically a zone principles as to how they're playing right now.
And Redick runs in and forces the steal.
The pass was telegraphed. Redick better than North Carolina passing.
So that's three turnovers and four trips against the zone. Williams has it stripped away, and it's good ball.
Noel, very strong inside, was able to block that before Williams could get it up.
Duke trying to stay in the top 10, maintain a high seed in the tournament. Ewing lays it in for the tying basket.
Jim, that inbounds pass was there a time or two ago, but they were not ready to release the ball to the cutter. That time, Duke executed perfectly. They stay in this matchup zone.
72 all, four straight empty trips for North Carolina.
McCants, a good perimeter shooter. This zone really giving North Carolina trouble. They're having so much fun one-on-one with McCants beating the guards. McCants got to be ready to take that shot.
Yeah, it looked like he was open for a flash.
He wasn't squared up to the basket.
4 seconds on the shot clock. Juwan Williams has to fire it over the backboard. Good ball.
It's a great call by Mike Krzyzewski to change defenses, and North Carolina still has not adjusted.
Let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Field goal percentages. North Carolina 61% first half, 54 overall. Complete stat, CBSSportsline.com.
Well, Florida State beat Duke by shooting 60% for the game. Kentucky shot 60% against North Carolina earlier this year. Tough shot.
Dante Jones kicked out to Duhon.
Guard. Duhon does not want to take the outside jump shot. He had it. He was wide open. Mike Krzyzewski is telling him to take that jump shot. Jim, do you remember up in Philadelphia in the NCAA tournament? Southern Cal, where Duhon did not want to take the shot. Mike Krzyzewski said, you've got to take the jump shot and really move them forward in that ball game. Change the complexion of it completely. When you're open, you've got to be able to take what's there.
Went on, of course, to be a starter on that championship team in Minneapolis, had 7 assists and only 1 turnover in the title game against Arizona.
Very difficult to penetrate with the dribble here.
McCants, three-pointer for the lead.
He is an excellent outside shooter as well.
McCants with 26. 1 minute to play.
Manuel on Redick,
Ewing for the tie.
Over the top goes Williams. Great rebound.
Stolen away. Felton up ahead. Manuel. Redick is back. Manuel take it to him. Gets the roll for the 5-point lead.
Duke needs to get it down here. Maybe go timeout and get that ball outside to Redick for a three.
Timeout Duke. 5 unanswered by a Carolina.
Krzyzewski now saying he never called a timeout. Mike Krzyzewski saying I did not call a timeout. The referees blew the whistle with anticipation that I was going to call it.
Did you see Duhon driving with the ball, looking around saying, wait a minute, I didn't see it either.
Now 46 seconds down, 5. Duke can go for 2 or 3 here. I think we'll see a penetration going for 2. There's plenty of time left, and they will get the ball back. Taking up too much time here.
Ewing tries to go inside. Last touch by North Carolina. 21 on the shot clock, 34 seconds left in the game.
Jim, if you're thinking 2, you ought to penetrate, drive to the basket, look for the kick out. You're thinking 3, you might as well take it quicker.
Jones, that's a 3. Got it! And it's down to 2. 77-75.
What a second half for this senior.
It's a timeout this time. 32 seconds left. Carolina basketball, two-point lead.
Jim, I think if you're Duke, you got to go back to the man-to-man defense right now, and I would go ahead and switch Dante Jones and put him on McCants because he's the only guy that matches up. That means Duhon has got the responsibility on Felton. You cannot stay in that 2-3 zone now because North Carolina does not have to score anymore to win.
Carolina has lost games this year at the free throw line, and they may have to, well, reverse that trend here today to win it.
Full court pressure. Here it's going to be Dockery on Felton. Remember, he got called for hand checks earlier.
On high, Felton is bumped, and it'll be a one and one. That's the 19th foul. The Chevrolet most valuable players in the game. Sheldon Williams tying a career high 20. And Rashad McCants, 26. From North Carolina, Chevrolet makes a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need.
Well, obviously, two free throws here, Jim, put it into that two-possession game. One just keeps it in the one-possession game, so everything riding on Felton. One of the outstanding high school players in America last year. Much expected of him. No bigger shots than these.
Carolina clears out of the lane. All Duke underneath. One and one, and he buries the first.
Now, if you're Duke, it's a two-possession game. You don't need a three. But you've got to get a shot off right away if he makes this. Buries him.
79-75 with 24 seconds left.
And Duke has no timeouts left either. Remember that.
Timeout this time, North Carolina. Count out anyone here in this one. This storied history, there have been some monumental comebacks in the closing seconds.
Remember the year Mike Krzyzewski, 95, was out with his ball club. His team took a much underrated Duke team, or underdog Duke team, took a two overtime game to North Carolina before losing.
And Walter Davis in 1974 brought it back from 8 down, 17 seconds left.
Too much time being spent by Duke here.
Jones, oh, some thought he traveled, but a foul called on North Carolina.
But Duke took too much time on the penetration.
Called on Noel. It'll be a one and one for Jones.
Remember, Duke does not have any timeouts. So whatever strategy Mike Krzyzewski has employed, he's got to use it. I'm kind of surprised that Williams is in the game right now because he needs defensive players when North Carolina gets the ball. Williams doesn't match up as well as Casey Sanders might out there.
16.4 seconds, down four. Dante Jones, one and one. From this point forward, it'll be double bonus for each side. Rest of the way.
74% free throw shooter. Here is that change. Dockery ready to go in the game if this shot is made. Get Williams out of there.
Long, two for two.
Here's the move that I anticipated. Let's see who's coming out of there.
It's Dockery for the shooter, Jones.
Wait a minute. Let's see who's going out. Is Dante going out of the game?
Yeah. He's out.
Well, they wanted the immediate foul. It wasn't called.
And a reach in. That's going to be it for Ewing.
Mike Krzyzewski trying to steal as many seconds as he can. He wanted the foul on the inbounds pass. Would have been a matter of seconds save.
It'll be Ewing's fifth. He will foul out with six. He's their third leading scorer on the season, top bench scorer.
Jim, obviously critical fouls here because plenty of time with 9-5 to go to get off a good offensive look if you're Duke.
Dante Jones returns to that Duke lineup.
10 team fouls. They get a chance to shoot two.
It'll be Noel at the line. He is not a good free throw shooter.
Young man got his first start against Iona this year and has really moved into this lineup and very productive.
Got two shots. He's 11 for 29 on the season. Wouldn't know it with that one. Now the critical one.
He can seal it there. He can create a two-possession game.
First recruited by the Carolina football team as a receiver. He's here playing his own way. Will be scholarship next year. And he earns it at the line.
Matt Doherty calls the timeout. That gives him a chance to adjust his defense.
They've got the four-point lead. Only 9 seconds remaining. Tonight on CBS, 60 Minutes, My Big Fat Greek Life, Becker and return to the Batcave. Holy upset in the making here, Batman.
What North Carolina doesn't want to do is allow Duke to roll this ball in right here. And they don't.
Duhon
to the basket.
Scott defending. Duhon puts it up, gets the roll. What a move. 3.6 left. And a reach in. Jones, 3 seconds exactly.
Now, Jim, you have a little different situation. Even if Felton were to miss these free throws, Duke would have to really get the ball down court with a pass. That 3 seconds makes it pretty difficult to go the length of the floor in a dribble.
Remember, Carolina lost that overtime game to NC State this year, hitting 7 out of 19 from the line. They are 7 for 7 in the second half. Felton's already hit 2 big ones. Make it 3 down the stretch.
And he makes this, and this ball game is over. Terrific effort by the North Carolina team.
For Duke. Jones behind the back puts it up.
I don't think he made it in time.
I think it left the hand too late. They'll review it, I'm sure. Jones makes the shot on the run. They still have not given a signal here.
No, Mike Krzyzewski gave the signal and he said not in time.
Yeah, but the officials haven't.
I don't think there's any doubt about this one.
It sure looked with the naked eye.
Yep. Zero.
There's no question, not in time. They storm the court at Chapel Hill. North Carolina has knocked off its arch rival Duke. The officials are still checking the replay. They just need to see this for confirmation. Watch the light. The light was already on.
The light way above that 0-0. The light was on. There's no question about the call. Jeff Capel hit one to send it in overtime back to 95. But Dante Jones, look at nobody guarding him whatsoever.
Just a split second. Too late.
Well, I'd say
look at the top of the shot clock. There you see. And as you look at this, the officials are reviewing it as well.
No question. But no question about it going downtown, huh?
Oh, my. Well, how about this? If Maryland beats Virginia tonight, then Carolina and Duke will meet in the ACC tournament in Greensboro on Friday. Duke the 3 seed, Carolina would be the 6th if Maryland beats Virginia. If Virginia beats Maryland, Duke would play Virginia on Friday and Carolina would go against Maryland. But that's a season maker for this young Carolina Tar Heel team. Matt Doherty's team surprises Duke here. Boy, it had its moments, didn't it? It was intense from the start. We'll see you on Selection Weekend. Jim and Billy, until next week. So long, everybody.